Hello everyone, my name is Adrian Błonka and hope you are doing well. Today we will keep focusing on modeling the abutments and concrete between beams in our steel and reinforced concrete complex bridge. I will show this those parts. I meant this part in beams range right here on this side and on the other side also. And furthermore, this part of abutment without wings and without soil's stiffness. Furthermore, according to a viewer's suggestion, we will provide an possibility to change the shape of the deck from the rectangular one into parallelogram. So keep watching and stay. Let's start with making a possibility to change the angle of this deck. I suggest to highlight all of the components that will be affected by this change of deck's angle. Beams will be affected and deck, and also corresponding coupling between flanges and web and between deck and upper flanges. Firstly, let's focus on beams because they are more simple to change, and look, or better, find the component that define all of this data. We can see that it is those these lines, so the lines on the base level. Now, next, let's check from which those lines are created. They are created from those points at the end and from these points at the beginning. Furthermore, those points at the end based on this vector and these points. So in general, all of the stuff right here is creating is created, sorry, basic on those points. So if we change the way how these points are defined, then we will change all the geometry that is created after these points. So let's now focus on them, and we can see that they base on the base point, which is permanent in our model, and on these vectors in X direction, which are made from the information from the list, which contains all of the information about spacing between beams. So we can change the coordinates of those points by rotating the X vector. How we will do it? Just use the component rotate vector. You can find it in category vector and subcategory vectors. Vector. Okay. This input needs our base vector that will be rotated. Next one is the axis, the rotation axis. So just use the z-axis in this case, and the last one is the rotation angle in radians. So if we create a slider which will contain information about the rotation angle, we have to remember to change the units from degrees to radians. Okay, to measure angle. Okay, and now use the component which changes degrees into radians. We can find it in maths category and subcategory trigonometry. There are two similar components. One changes the radians into degrees, and the second one changes degrees into radians. We need the second one, so just take it. Now we rotate it those vectors in this way if we use positive angle like 20 degrees. Okay, now we have to elongate them. Why? If you look more mathematically, you can see that there is x axis, there is y axis, and our vectors are defined right here. Oh. In next step, we rotated them, so we create these vectors. Okay, now we have to elongate these rotated vectors to get something like that, because we want the x component of this resultant vector to be equal x component of the original vector. Okay, we will do it by dividing the length of this vector by cosine of this angle. Okay, let's just highlight this infographics. I think we can also make the order. I don't see this option. No, never mind. Okay, so just use the cosine component and divide those vectors by cosine and change the values of this piece. You can see that all beams and couplings between flanges and webs are made correctly. Deck needs some changes, but before that, let's create our own component which makes all of the stuff so rotating and division by zero. Highlight all of these components, click scroll on your mouse and use the cluster option. Okay, we created the cluster. There is an original vector. Okay, vectors even. There is rotation degree angle, rotation angle in degrees. Okay, because we change the units inside of this component. Okay, and there is a rotated vectors. Okay, we can hide then this input of angle and just copy this component to the DEX definition section and change exactly rotate all the x vectors in this area. Okay, you can see that this change was applied and the deck looks better, but it's not enough. We have to also change these vectors, so this one even better, and the last one is right here. Okay, and as you can see, deck is fixed now. We can check it in the dat file, so just calculate the teddy and you can see that deck was correctly rotated without any bugs. You can see that couplings between flanges and webs are defined correctly for first half of the bridge and the second half of the bridge, and furthermore couplings between deck and upper flanges are also made correctly, and this area where first half transform to second half is also correctly modeled. Okay, so now let's go back to our Grasshopper, where we will define the concrete in beams range. This part will be divided into several sub parts. I will show you that on our base model. Here it is. You can see, maybe in this perspective it will be more intuitive. Here is a concrete part of the abutment between the middle of the deck and the upper edge of the upper flanges. Next we have two small parts, narrow parts which are defined in range of upper flanges, and each of them has a height equal to half of the thickness of the flanges. Okay, next we have in this case two elements, but we will have only one element in web's range. And next we have similar to the upper part of this steel cross section, two elements in bottom flanges range. Okay, you can say, somebody could say that this model is wrong, and I totally agree with this guy. Why? Because in this range we have rigid couplings, and there is not rigid element, and when some phenomena like shrinkage and temperature will be applied into our model as a load case, then stresses in those components, in these components, will be unreal. So during the automatic design of reinforcement in concrete structure, I just set those elements, so this one, these two narrow elements, and these two narrow elements, to not be included in this design process. And I take the reinforcement from the webs part of this abutment, and elongate this reinforcement into those elements when I make a final report. Okay, so to do this we have to define all of the points at this level, at this level, this level, this, this, and this one. So six levels in total. Okay, so let's move on to our grasshopper and just find the first level, because we have already modeled it. These points are needed. We have to make the division between the beams as we did it for the deck. So generally we can use points from deck's level, not from the abutment, from the base level. So let's do it. Where are those points? I think that they should be somewhere right here. The lines, division, okay, so they should be there. Let's check if order of those points, of these points, is correct. Let me check. Okay, understood. Dobra. Okay, so everything is correct then. So now just move them below, and so on and so on. Okay, refer to these points. Okay, now what to do? Okay, here and here. Okay, so those points and those points. So firstly we will take the points from the beginning of lines definition. Those points will be taken into account later. Now use component add and find the correct vectors. We need a vector from the middle of the decks to upper edge of upper flange. So let's move on. I think right here. Yes, here we have this. Let's create vector z, which will take the half of the dex thickness, and change the sign to negative because we have to go down, no up, as we did previously. Add those vectors so we can see that everything is now correct. Next, we have to create another vector with length of half of flange's thickness. Here we have it. Okay, go. Okay, you can also make a component from these two components just to shorten our work. Okay, so points in the middle of the deck, now upper edge of upper flanges, middle of upper flanges, and bottom of upper flanges. Okay, now we need upper edge of bottom flanges, so we have to use height of the web. Okay, do the same stuff for it. Okay, and next one will be this one because flanges are symmetrical. Okay, we have all of our points. Now we can check the set's order. Those are the first points. Second, and so on. So I think everything is correct. We can use our first defined component, which cut off the ends of our lists, and check if everything is okay. So use this component, and as you can see, everything is correct, I guess. Yes, it is everywhere. Okay, and repeat this this work to lower parts. Okay, narrow elements are created. Last, first, and the same here. Last, first, and the last one. Last, first. Okay. Save, and now we can create the sophistic component which made areas, structural areas. Apply all of those outputs. Maybe it's better to make them separately, because adding trees when we have fixed number of those elements is unnecessary complication of our code. So I just left it as it is now. Number and group are not needed now. Thickness is not already it's not defined, so let's just do it from 0.4 to 1.2 with one centimeter of precision. Okay, and it will be walls thickness in meters. Okay, and let's set it to 60 centimeters. Okay, thickness was set. Material and reinforcement material will be the same as for deck. So let's look here. Concrete has number 1 and steel has number 10. We can copy it from there. Okay, material and reinforced material. Next, Z direction. Z direction is okay for me because I always want the local Z coordination of walls and wings to be pointed to the center of the soil, which will be here. I mean, in our base model, it is like that. Oh, as you can see, all local Z axes of walls are pointed right to the inside of the soil, which will be made here. Okay. So flipping Z is unnecessary, and most the most important for us, mesh options. Use single quad mesh options, and everything else is okay. And just apply those components into our Sophie MSHC component. Okay, and see the results. Okay, as you can see, this concrete panels were created with the same division as Dex division, so we can move on and so we can keep going and making another components. Everything there will be the same, so let's just hide all of those lines and just change the bread input. First one, second one. Let's make it in more order. Okay. And now create a peel and combine all of these outputs into the pin peel. Okay, upgrade the geometry and calculate everything again. It's quite fast, and now we have concrete in beams range fully modeled on the first side. So let's keep going and repeat this process for the other side. And to do this, we only have to change those points, which we have already defined. They are right here. So let's just copy it and substitute these points into this one. Okay, as you can see, panels were created correctly, but the local Z coordinates is opposite as we want them to be. So use the volume toggle and change the flip Z input everywhere, because they are defined in the same way. Flip Z, flip Z, flip Z, and the last one, flip Z. Okay, and apply those components into this peel. And check the results. Like this is our first side, and there is other side, and as you can see, it's also correctly modeled. Orientation is also as we want it to be inside the soil, which will be modeled here. Modeled, not modeled, but applied. The load of soil will be applied here. Wave, weight to be more exact. Okay, so that's it for concrete in beams range. So let's group it and also add those components into this group, because everything there is a part of definition of deck. Save, and now we will move on to abutments. While modeling the abutments, we have to remember about the points that will be then used to create wings and foots. I will show you that. I meant those points in this edge to create the wings on two sides and also on the other side of the bridge, and also those points to create foot, to be more exact, the connection between the foot and walls, because the bottom part of those walls ends exactly when the upper edge of foot starts. Okay, so and this is the reason why I use the kinematic constraints to take into account the stiffness, the real stiffness of the concrete, and be able to apply the load, the soil and other types of loads on the wings and walls correctly. Okay, so let's move to our Grasshopper file and find the points that are defined on this edge. So in our current model, we need the last points that we created. Okay, so let's find them. They should be there. Okay, so we can use the point component to take those points lower, and now we have to define the height of the walls. Let's begin from 2 up to 8, I guess, with 1 centimeter of precision. It will be walls height in meters. Height in meters. Now create a vector in Z direction. Let's set this value up to 5, and we have to make this value negative because we have to go down in our model in the opposite of the Z, in Z's global direction. Okay, add those points and this vector. Now we created points on the upper edge of the foot. Now we need to create lines between upper points and lower points, and then we will divide those lines in walls height direction, as we did when we modeled beams, especially flanges. Okay, so go to curves category, and then in primitives we can find lines. I prefer to always define lines from the top to the bottom and keep the same convention. Sorry. Okay, now divide those lines from minimum 4 to even 20 sometimes. Set this up to 6. I think it's enough. Okay, but before that we have to, I think we have to we have to cut the ends of this list, as we did to create the deck's surfaces. But let me check that before it. Simplify those lists. We have two points, so I guess it's not correct. So we have to do it. So just use our first created component, use last and last ones, and now repeat this process for those points. And now we should see the result. Okay, so here are top left points, here are bottom left points, top right points and bottom right points. So I think it's everything is correctly defined. Now we can just make a 4-point surface. Okay, it looks good. Now use the structural surface component from Sophistic. Walls thickness is the same for concrete between beams and the concrete below beams. So thickness can be set with hidden line. So sorry. Material is the same, reinforcement is the same. We want to have control of the flip Z input and also copy the single quad. Okay, the rest is the same as previously, except breadth input. Okay, let me see the local Z component, local Z coordination, local Z coordinate system. It's pointed correctly into soil's direction, so we don't have to flip the Z, and we also use single quad, so that's enough for it. Now just apply the results and see them in Teddy. Upload F12. Okay. And we see that walls looks pretty well. Let's check the thickness. Thickness is also the same as for the concrete between beams. And also we can see that we have to make those walls more thicker. So let's do this. Where is the thickness? Thickness is right here. I think 90 centimeters will be fairly enough. And we have to also remember that we want those walls to be to have the same thickness. So let's just do this. I should do it previously, but it doesn't matter. Okay, next we have to just substitute those vectors, those points into those points. So not those points. Okay, copy this input, this all components, and substitute points. Where they are here. Okay, second wall is created, but I guess we have to change the orientation of local Z coordinate vector. Yes, and it's true. Okay, now it's pointed inside the soil, and also we want this variable to be as the same as this variable, which divide those walls in height direction. So use peel component and just substitute it, and now we can apply those surfaces into our code and check the results in Sophistic. Okay. And second wall was created, and walls are thicker now. Okay, we can also check if everything is correct when it comes to orientation of local coordinate system. Yes, it is. Everything is pointed inside the soils. Okay, so That's it. Let's make some short summary. Today we learned how to make some little changes in our model. In this example, we were able to change the angle of the deck, and that's why now we have a full control of the shape of this parallelogram deck. Next, we defined the concrete between beams, and we also learned that some parts of our model will not be considered in design process. In this example, there were two types of those elements: the concrete between the middle of the deck and the upper edge of the upper flanges, and also those concrete components in range of both flanges. And the last one, we learned how to create the abutments walls, and think up and taking into account that then in next step we will need to take those points from the vertical edge of those surfaces, and also the bottom points of the abutment wall. So thank you a lot for watching. Consider subscribing and liking those videos, and if you have some suggestions for next videos, just leave it in the below. I will do what can be done to apply those suggestions in next videos. And if there will not be an opportunity to do it in this model, I will use them in next models. So again, thank you a lot for watching, and see you later.